Hello, you are rolling with Nat 20. I'm Nat 20, and today we will be looking at the basics of KeeperRL as it is in its Alpha 10 version. We will need to cut into the mountain a little and create some essential rooms for our dungeon. We will map out some other plots for rooms a little bit later. The goal of the game is to build a dungeon and keep the Keeper alive. To win, we must then conquer the five factions that exist on this map. Our imps will be doing the manual labor for this dungeon. Mining, woodcutting, and gathering are all tasks for them to handle. We can spend some mana to summon more imps to get the tasks done faster, but with each imp, the mana cost rises. Right now our resources are at zero despite the wood we cut and the ore we mine. That is because we need to build a storage area to keep it all. Once the area is built, our imps will bring our resources to it, and the supply will be counted. When mining ores from locations not intended to be part of our dungeon, it is wise not to connect the new mines to our dungeon. We don't want to accidentally create a back door for dwarves and bandits to get in. The library is extremely important, as it will be what we primarily use to gain mana throughout the game. It also unlocks the ability to research new things and expand our dungeon's capabilities. Each library tile only costs 20 wood, so feel free to build big. Since this is where our keeper will hang out and we need to protect him, it is important to build the library deep into the dungeon. It is important to be aware of room efficiency. Room efficiency is determined by lighting and adjacent like tiles. With this in mind, some rooms, like our library, forge, lab, and training area, will all require the use of torches. We now acquire monsters through means of migration as opposed to the way we summoned our imps. We need a place for the monsters to live, so we'll have to build some dorms. And since we need gold for our monsters now, it's important not to expand too quickly. With our library, we can now research various things to improve our dungeon at the cost of mana. It is important to visit the research tab regularly and pick up options like crafting, ironworking, alchemy, sorcery, archery, and two-handed weaponry in order to have the ability to outfit our troops and protect our keeper. While we wait for our creatures to arrive, we will build a forge so that we can build weapons and armor further down the line. With the release of Alpha 10, gold has become much more important as we now need to pay our monsters. In order to store our gold, we will need a treasure room. It is important to put the treasure room away from the entrance as dirty, skeeving bandits will try and steal our gold, and we need our gold to pay our powerful monsters. We are going to need both a place for our creatures to grow in strength as well as to figure out how to protect our keeper. We can accomplish both by building a training area at the very entrance of our dungeon. Anyone trying to come in will have to deal with our best forces first. If you haven't already, a door to the dungeon will slow enemies down a bit to give you the time to strategize. This method is especially effective if you leave an eye or two outside to watch the place. If we expand our dorms, we'll open the doors to stronger creatures like the ogres and the goblin shamans. As we get more varied creatures, it makes sense to give them commands based on their attributes. Gnomes are excellent craftsmen and potion makers, ogres can train to become some of our strongest forces, and the shamans can join the keeper in study to accelerate our mana growth. It might be nice to vary our troops a little, so we will build a beast lair to house our more ferocious creatures. Aside from equipment, we can outfit our troops with an assortment of offensive and defensive potions. One way of getting these potions is by purchasing them at the black market, but a more practical method is to build a lab and begin making our own. Death is inevitable. Whether it be your troops or your fallen foes, there will be a body count. With a graveyard, we can make these corpses useful yet again. Imps will bring the bodies of the fallen to an empty grave and then bury it. From these graves, our undead army rises. It is important to remember to build the dragon shrine and have somebody constantly worship it. Otherwise...
My dungeon's on fire!
Oh man, everyone's dead!
Be aware of your current gold and the cost of the next pay period. If you're unable to pay your creatures, they will simply sleep all day and leave your no-good, lousy, not-gold-given keeper nearly defenseless. If you find yourself running low but cannot find more gold ore to mine, each of the factions you must defeat will have some gold for you to take. And what better time to risk your monsters' lives than right before they would risk yours? Sometimes you may find your keeper in a sticky situation. Hopefully, when this happens, you are prepared. The keeper will outfit himself with equipment from the armory. Archery is especially useful for our keeper. If we're lucky enough to have sorcery, or even advanced sorcery, our options that we have when in trouble increase. With sorcery, we get a few useful spells. Haste Self will allow us to make more actions, making it possible for our Keeper to do more things before a turn is up. Summon Insects will create a few weak monsters that will take a few hits, distract the enemy, and hopefully even damage our opponents. Deception will create a few copies of the Keeper to confuse our enemies. If we're fortunate enough to have advanced magic, we then have access to spells that will buff our strength and dexterity. We can use Escape in case things get too bad. So long as the Keeper survives, we can rebuild and reclaim what we have lost. Beware though, Fire Sphere is a powerful offensive spell that will burn the library to the ground if you use it while inside. Ravens are not the most defensive units, and when left alone, they will explore the map and spy on our enemy towns. If we have a little spare time, we can even possess them and explore the map on our own more efficiently. If you happen to load into this screen, possess your Keeper and use the mouse to right-click and drag a little. This should move the camera back to your Keeper where you can unpossess him and play like normal. This concludes our KeeperRL Alpha 10 tutorial. This game is still in early access, so there's lots more to come. For just $15, you can head over to the website and pick up a copy of the alpha version for yourself. You can even try a free ascii version of the game available as the demo. It includes everything in the game except for the art and the sound. KeeperRL is currently on Steam Greenlight, so you should feel free to go vote and help get it on Steam.
Go do it!
Links are in the description below. I hope you found this video useful. Be sure to check back for tutorials on future updates.
Or subscribe and make your YouTube do the work for you.
You can go ahead and leave any comments or questions below. I'd love to hear from you guys. As always, I'm Nat20, and you've been rolling with Nat20, and I'll see you guys later.